About 40 years ago, more precisely in 1978, I had the great privilege to meet the legendary composer from Greece, Mikis Theodorakis. Everybody knows his music, especially the famous Sirtaki, you know, that Greek, typical Greek dance in the movie Zorba the Greek, the movie in which was made in the 60s with the director, the famous Cypriot from Cyprus director, Michael Kakoyannis, Michalis Kakoyannis. And Anthony Quinn was playing in that movie the role of Zorba the Greek. And you also had this other great Greek actress, Irini Papas. So, you know, the Sirtaki, pa-bam, ta-dam, ta-ga-da-gam. Anyway, I met Theodorakis because I knew his agent, a wonderful man called Norbert Gamson. Norbert was not only the director of the most important jazz festival in France, which used to take place in Antibes, Jean-les-Pins, on the French Riviera. But he was also an incredible classical piano fan, and he was also an excellent pianist. Guess what? At the École Normale de Musique de Paris, in Paris, he got his concert license with Liszt Concerto No. 2, and he was the artistic the producer of some of the most famous piano records at EMI. Ravel Concerto with Rachmaninoff No. 4 Piano Concerto with Michelangeli and the Philharmonia Orchestra of London, and also several recordings by Georgi Tsifra, my idol, among them the Transcendental Studies of Liszt. Anyway, he was also an agent. He was the agent of Mikis Theodorakis. He was the agent of Keith Jarrett. I made a connection between him and my friend Chick Corea. And anyway, there was also a very interesting man, a French-Greek man called Jean Katsiapis. And he wanted to organize a concert at the Salle Pleyel in Paris with Theodorakis. And he introduced me, you know, to Theodorakis. I met Norbert Gamson, and there was an idea that I take part at this concert. I played during maybe 20-25 minutes, and I included for the first time my newly composed composition, the Cypriot Rhapsody, Rhapsody Cypriot, because this concert was a benefit concert for the refugees of the victims of the war, which occurred in Cyprus 4 years earlier, in 1974. And this is why I wrote this piece. The idea behind all this was to get acquainted with Theodorakis in order to consider playing his piano concerto number one, more precisely. So I learned the concerto, and then I played it in the early 80s in Eastern Germany with the Symphonic Orchestra of Halle, the birth city of Handel, by the way. We played it in Halle and also in East Berlin in the big hall Palace der Republik, and this concert was taped and you can see it on YouTube. And we recorded the piano concerto, the suite for piano and orchestra, and the second symphony, The Song of the Earth, which also has a big piano part. We recorded it with the Radio Television Symphony Orchestra, the RTL Symphony Orchestra, of in the Grand Duchy of Luxembourg, under the conducting of Mikis Theodorakis himself. So, during the recording in Luxembourg of those pieces, we also had performances at the International Festival of Echternach in Luxembourg and also in Belgium. Then during those years I was thinking about composing a piece, a piano piece between 12 and 14 minutes on some of the most famous tunes of Zorba, the Greek music. And well, I didn't find the time to do it then, in the 80s. We're still in the early 80s now. And I have to tell you a nice little story, by the way. I cannot forget an incredible event which happened in Mexico a little bit before those years, at the end of the 70s. I was invited at a dinner for the birthday of the First Lady of Mexico, Doña Carmen Romano de López Portillo, the wife of President José López Portillo. And at that dinner, there were maybe something like 100 people. I shall never forget the astronaut. There was an American astronaut who brought a beautiful picture of the Mexican flag he put on the moon. But more interesting even, Anthony Quinn was there, the great Mexican actor who played Zorba the Greek. And Mrs. López Portillo had a piano in the middle of that big living room, well, it was a big hall, the presidential residence. And she asked me to play, and suddenly I remembered maybe I should improvise on Sirtaki, the famous stats of Zorba the Greek. And Mr. Anthony Quinn came near the piano while I was playing. He took with one hand the President of Mexico and with the other hand the First Lady of Mexico. And while I was playing, ba-bam, ta-ga-da-gam, he showed them how to dance the Sirtaki. It was very nice. Later on in the 80s, Theodorakis was asked by the Verona Festival in Italy to write a ballet based on the music of the movie Zorba the Greek. And he spent 8 months in his flat here in Paris preparing the score and adding quite a lot of music. Then he gave me the score and I was so impressed by the wealth, the musical wealth of this music, the huge variety. There were so many themes which I never heard before that I decided to really now sit down and write that piano piece. But it would have been impossible to stay within the frame of 12 to 14 minutes. And because of my concerts and recordings, I could not find the time until 2005. In 2005, I was in the jury of the first international Beethoven competition in Bonn, and I started writing this piece when I found 2 hours here, 2 hours there. The piece was finished in Clearwater, Florida, in January 2007, 2 years later, at about 2 a.m. in the night. And I remember very precisely. It was very, very funny. And the piece now has 53 pages, or no, 52 pages, excuse me, 52 pages, the manuscript, and it lasts 53 minutes. Recently, I made some very, very slight changes. And then after I finished writing it, I thought, my goodness, when shall I find the time to learn this huge work for piano? I spoke about it to Mikis Theodorakis and he wanted to listen to it. He says, I'm getting old, I want to listen to this recording, I want to listen. Then I met him in 2012. I had a concert in February at the Concert Hall of Athens, the beautiful Megaron of Athens, where I played his piano concerto, the number one, the one I had recorded with him. And although he had some mobility problems, he couldn't move easily, he came to the concert. And at the end of the concert, I improvised a little bit on music of Zorba. And I addressed him in front of the audience. And I told him, Mikis, I know that you are very upset with me because I have not yet recorded this big piece, but I brought you a Xerox, a photocopy of the manuscript. Here it is. And something funny, at the intermission, right after this, We were in the foyer, and he was there with a young man and three or four gentlemen. And I was sitting next to this young man who was maybe about 36, 37 years old. He introduced me. He says, "This is Alexis Tsipras." I didn't know that name. I didn't know about his political party, who is now, as you know, the Prime Minister of Greece. Then I had really to do something. I mean, Theodorakis is now in 2017, if I don't mistake myself. He's about 92 years old. He has some health problems. So anyway, I organized myself this year in 2017, and I recorded in spring this piece. And when we finished the recording, I suddenly wanted to improvise on some of the most famous songs of Theodorakis. And we also added three original piano pieces by him to show the diversity of his musical genius, because we should never forget that before he wrote about 1,000 popular songs and all this other music, more popular and political and blah, blah, blah. Before that, he was first a serious music composer. You know, he studied with Olivier Messiaen in his famous class at the Paris Conservatoire, which was attended by people like Pierre Boulez, Stockhausen, I think Luigi Nono, and many more. So he was first a symphonist. You know, he wrote several symphonies, two piano concertos, chamber music, and so on. So now the CD is ready, and you will be able to get it, I think, around the end of the year. Thank you for listening. Meanwhile, till the CD gets released, we are pleased to offer you 7 excerpts of my Grande Fantaisie sur Zorba, une rhapsodie grecque. Grand or great, as you wish. Fantasy on Zorba, with the subtitle A Greek Rhapsody. And I am dedicating this work to the Greek people. Ευχαριστώ. Thank you.